Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, let's do the current affairs for 14th of July 2019. So let's start the video. Before I start, here is a Sunday quiz for you. Which bank is giving a loan of 30,000 crore for Delhi-Meerut rapid rail corridor? It will connect Delhi with the western UP's city called Meerut. There is a 5-year vision plan called EQIP. It's an initiative of which Ministry of India? Project EQIP. It's a name of the 5-year vision plan. Who recently became the first Indian woman to scale Mount Makalu, which is the 5th highest peak in the world? Who has become the brand ambassador for TAFE's Massey Ferguson tractors? TAFE is basically a company, Tractor and Farm Equipment Limited. Which team won the 16th Sudirman Cup 2019? Sudirman Cup. And Sudirman Cup is played for which sport? That also you need to mention. Let's start now. Which player has won the women's single title at the Wimbledon 2019? So this year, so far there have been 3 Grand Slams that have been done. First is the Australian Open, then French Open, and now Wimbledon. Australian Open was won by Naomi Osaka of Japan. French Open was won by Ashleigh Barty of Australia. She is right now the world number one player. And Wimbledon is now won by Simona Halep of Romania. She defeated powerful Serena Williams in the final. Wimbledon is the oldest tennis tournament in the world. Which state is all set to become the first state in India to have a proper water policy? Which state are we talking about? We are talking about Meghalaya. Meghalaya's capital is Shillong, which is the 100th smart city of India. Now, Meghalaya was also in news because there is a stadium called Dikki Bandi Stadium. They are renaming it after P.A. Sangma. Also, there is a festival. There are 2 festivals, in fact, that you know of Meghalaya. One is called Behdiyan Klam Festival. It is of Meghalaya. And there is one more. It's a dance festival called Nong Krem. And these days, questions regarding fairs and festivals are very common. Also, the longest river bridge of India is being formed, which will connect Dhubri in Assam with Fulbari in Meghalaya. Okay? The longest river bridge in India, which is under construction, will connect Dhubri in Assam with Fulbari in Meghalaya. And National Sports Stadium for the Disabled is also being made in Meghalaya. National Sports Stadium for Disabled. Now, don't get confused between National Sports Stadium and National Sports University. National Sports University is coming up in Manipur. Right? And there is a Balfakram National Park in Meghalaya. Balfakram National Park. There is also Nokrek National Park. So I think that's enough for now. And Conrad Sangma is the CM. Who has been appointed as the next Managing Director and Chief Financial Officer of the World Bank? World Bank's president is David Malpass. In fact, he tweeted yesterday that we have selected Anshula Kant as the Managing Director and Chief Financial Officer of the World Bank. David Malpass is the president. He is from America. Another Indian that is at a very high position is Geeta Gopinath. She is the Chief Economist of the IMF. The Union Government has initiated a project worth around 33 crore rupees for the conservation and protection of which species? This species needs to be protected because it is critically endangered right now. Critically endangered means if not enough care is taken immediately, then it will become extinct very soon. It is the Great Indian Bustard. Great Indian Bustard, which is found mainly in Punjab, Gujarat, Rajasthan, etc. Who is our Environment Minister? Prakash Javadekar. As per the IHS market report, India is poised to surpass which country to be the third largest economy in the world by 2025? So, in 2025, India will become the third largest economy only after America and China. So the answer is Japan. India will overtake Japan to become the third largest economy. Right now we are almost a $2.7 trillion economy and we want to become a $5 trillion economy by 2025. The world's biggest diamond mine called Arigal Diamond Mine is located in which country? It will be shut down by the end of 2020. It is the world's biggest diamond mine and has been for the last lot of years. And this diamond mine is owned by a company called Rio Tinto. Rio Tinto. It is located in Western Australia. Gitanas Noseda. He has become the new president of which country? This country is Lithuania. What is the capital of Lithuania? Vilnius. Who has been chosen as the health ambassador of Mission Shakti, which stands for School-Based Health Awareness, Knowledge Test and Training Initiative, launched by Indian Council of Medical Research? What is his name? Actually, Mahatma Gandhi has been made the health ambassador. Mahatma Gandhi. Which state government has announced to observe 12th of July every year as Save Water Day? Save Water Day will be observed by the government of West Bengal. Who has been appointed as the secretary for Consular, Passport, Visa and Overseas Indian Affairs in the Ministry of External Affairs, headed by S. Jayashankar? What is the name? Vikas Swaroop. He is a very good author also. He has written a book called Q&A. And on Q&A, it was actually this book on which the movie Slumdog Millionaire is based. So Slumdog Millionaire, the movie, is based on a book by Vikas Swaroop called Q&A. As per the Performance Grading Index 2017-18, which is the least performing state in the field of education in India? Least performing. It is Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh is the least performing state and Chandigarh is the best performing. Chandigarh is best performing, and out of all the states and union territories put together, second best is Kerala and third best is Gujarat. Arunachal Pradesh is least performing. The central government, they have banned which pro-Khalistan group for its anti-national activities? It is called the Six for Justice. Reebok has appointed which person as the brand ambassador? It is Katrina Kaif. Which state government has decided to form something known as NORCA? It is a non-resident investment company. They recently also started Pravasi Dividend Pension Scheme. We are talking about Kerala. So they have made something known as NORCA, which stands for Non-Resident Keralites Affairs. The first edition of Gandhi Mandela Peace Initiative took place where? Gandhi Mandela Peace Initiative, the first meeting took place in New Delhi. Nelson Mandela was born on 18th of July and his autobiography is called A Long Walk to Freedom. An agribusiness incubation center under the National Agriculture Development Scheme called Raftar, it has been started in which state? It has been started recently in Chhattisgarh and it was formed in Raipur, which is the capital of Chhattisgarh. Indian scientists at the Mumbai-based Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, they have created a unique material. What is the name of that material which will boost the solar panel and solve drinking water problem in India? It will be called Black Gold. So this was the video for 14th of July. And now let me quickly tell you the answers of the quiz that you have been waiting for. The bank that will finance the Delhi-Meerut Rapid Rail Corridor is the Asian Development Bank. EQIP is basically for upgradation of education. So it is an initiative of the HRD Ministry, headed by Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. His constituency is Haridwar. He is the HRD Minister, Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. Mount Makalu has been scaled by a woman from Satara. In Maharashtra, her name is Priyanka Mohite. Okay, she is from Satara. Satara is also the place where the first mega food park of Maharashtra has been opened. And the second mega food park of Maharashtra has been opened in Aurangabad. And the third mega food park of Maharashtra is being made in Wardha. It has not been opened yet, but okay, very soon. The Minister for Food Processing is Harsimrat Kaur Badal. Her Lok Sabha constituency is Bhatinda. Who has become the brand ambassador of tractor and farm equipment? There is a brand called Massey Ferguson Tractor. It is Akshay Kumar. Which team won the Sudirman Cup? It was won by China. They defeated Japan in the final by a score of 3-0. China won the Sudirman Cup. It is played for badminton. Now, where is the headquarter of Badminton World Federation? BWF, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, which is also the World Book Capital for 2020, declared by UNESCO. Okay, that's it. Enjoy your Sunday. Take adequate rest, adequate sleep. Catch up with everything. Do revision if possible. And today, we have the World Cup final. We also have, a match, Wimbledon final, where my favorite player, Roger Federer, is playing Novak Djokovic. So, yeah, Sunday, a lot to look forward to. And I'll see you tomorrow. We'll start a new week. Take care.